Hello friends, in the last video, we had seen first hypothesis test to compare the mean of two samples, that is two sample t-test in Microsoft Excel as well as Minitab software with the help of practical example. In this video, we are going to learn second hypothesis test to compare the mean of two samples, that is paired t-test in Microsoft Excel as well as Minitab software with the help of practical example for easy understanding and better clarity. So let's begin. Paired t-test. The paired t-test is used to determine whether the mean of the differences between two paired samples differs from zero or a target value, and to calculate a range of values that is likely to include the population mean of differences. The paired t-test is useful for analyzing the same set of atoms that were measured under two different conditions or differences in measurements made on the same subject before and after a treatment, or differences between two treatments given to the same subject. For example, a physiologist wants to determine whether a particular running program has an effect on resting heart rate. For this purpose, the heart rates of 20 randomly selected people were measured. The people were then put on the running program and measured again 1 year later. Thus, the before and after measurements for each person are a pair of observations. The physiologist then performs a paired t-test to determine whether the heart rates are different before and after the running program. Hypothesis for paired t-test. For paired t-test, the hypotheses are as follows. Null hypothesis: H0:μD is equal to mu0, that is, the population mean of differences μD equals to hypothesis mean of differences, that is mu0. And alternative hypothesis: select one of the following alternative hypothesis. H1:μD is not equal to mu0, that is, the population mean of differences μD does not equal to the hypothesized mean of differences mu0, or H1:μD is greater than mu0, that is, the population mean of differences μD is greater than the hypothesized mean of differences mu0, or H1:μD is less than mu0, that is, the population mean of differences μD is less than the hypothesized mean of differences mu0. Data considerations for paired t-test. To ensure that your results are valid, consider the following guidelines when you collect the data, perform the analysis, and interpret your results. 1. The data must be continuous. This type of data measures a characteristic of a part or process, such as length, weight, or temperature. The data often includes fractional or decimal values. 2. The sample data should not be severely skewed, and the sample size should be equal to or greater than 20. If your sample size is greater than 20 and the underlying distribution is unimodal and continuous, then the hypothesis test performs appropriately, even if the data is mildly skewed. If your sample size is less than 20, you should graph the data to check for skewness and unusual observations. If the data is severely skewed or has many unusual observations, use caution when you interpret the results. 3. The sample data should be selected randomly. In statistics, random samples are used to make generalizations or inferences about a population. If your data is not collected randomly, your results may not represent the population. 4. Data must have a set of paired or dependent observations, such as measurements on the same atom under different conditions. If you have two samples of independent observations, then use two sample t-test. And 5. Determine an appropriate sample size. Your sample size should be large enough so that the estimates have enough precision, the confidence intervals are narrow enough to be useful, and you have adequate protection against type 1 and type 2 errors. To determine the appropriate sample size for your hypothesis test, go to Power and Sample Size and then Paired t-test. I have already explained the detailed procedure for it in the General Procedure to Conduct Hypothesis Testing. If you want to see it, please click on this card. Example of paired t-test. A physiologist wants to determine whether a particular running program has an effect on resting heart rate. For this purpose, the heart rates of 20 randomly selected people were measured. The people were then put on the running program and measured again 1 year later. Thus, the before and after measurements for each person are a pair of observations. The physiologist then performs a PET test to determine whether the heart rates are different before and after the running program. Now, let's see the detailed procedure to conduct a PET test in Minitab and Microsoft Excel. A. Conduct a PET test in Minitab. To conduct a PET test in Minitab, please follow the procedure. 1. Select Stat, Basic Statistics, and then PET. 2. From the drop-down list, select Each sample is in a column. 3. In sample 1, enter before. 4. In sample 2, enter after. 5. In options, the confidence level is 95%, hypothesis difference as 0, and the alternative is not equal as defaults. Keep them as it is and click OK. 6. In graphs, select the type of graph you want to use for analysis. And 7. Click OK in each dialog box to get the results. We will get the results of an analysis in the session window and in graph window. Interpretation of results. In these results, the null hypothesis says that the mean differences of the pulse rate is 0, whereas the estimate for the paired difference in means of the resting heart rate is 2.2. We are also 95% confident that the paired difference in means is between 0.677 and 3.723. Because the p-value is 0.007, which is less than the significance level of 0.05, the physiologist rejects the null hypothesis and concludes that there is a significant difference between the heart rates of the test subject before and after the running program. In the box plot for differences, we can also see that there is a significant difference between the heart rates of the test subject before and after the running program. B. Conduct a PET test in Microsoft Excel. To conduct PET test in Microsoft Excel, please follow the procedure. 1. First of all, data need to be recorded into two columns. First column is for before heart rates and second column is for after heart rates. 2. On the data tab in the analysis group, click data analysis. If you can't find the data analysis button, then click on this card to see the detailed procedure to load the analysis tool pack add-in. 3. Select t-test, pair two samples for mean and click OK. 4. Click in the variable 1 range box and select the range A1 to A21. 5. Click in the variable 2 range box and select the range B1 to B21. 6. Click in the hypothesis mean difference box and type 0 as H0 colon mu d minus mu 0 is equal to 0. 7. Click in the output range box and select cell E2. And 8. Click OK to get the results. We will get the results at cell E2. Interpretation of results. An interpretation of results is same as the result from the Minitab. In these results, the null hypothesis states that the mean differences of the pulse rate is 0 because the p-value is 0.007, which is less than the significance level of 0.05, the physiologist rejects the null hypothesis and concludes that there is a difference between the heart rates of the test subjects before and after the running program. This is all about the PET test in Microsoft Excel as well as Minitab software with the help of a practical example. We will see the next hypothesis test with a practical example in the next video. For references, I have taken some part of this very detailed content from Minitab. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful, add your valuable comments and share this video to your friends and colleagues to improve and refresh their knowledge. If you want to get updates of such a videos from my channel, please do not forget to subscribe it and click on the bell icon and select to get all notifications. And finally, Thank you for watching.